Good evening, and welcome to the 40 and Slip. This is episode 125. What was the grade of the motor oil, Steve?
20W50.
Oh yeah, 20W50 episode. That's how Steve keeps his Volkswagen running.
Running cool.
Joining us again from across the pond. In the future, by the way, Steve. I would like to welcome Richard this week from tomorrow. Richard, how are things going?
Hello, Chris.
We have a problem. He's already talking over me because he's in the future.
I am in the future.
It's August 29th. How are things in the future, Richard?
Well, things haven't changed much. still pretty honest. I don't have any lottery numbers for you or anything.
That doesn't help me.
You suck. You suck at being a time traveler.
It's like the worst time travel in the history of mankind.
John Teeter, you are not.
No, I have not prevented the second American Civil War.
Richard was trying to be John Teeter and go back and get the anti-Cathera mechanism.
Instead, I wound up a day in the future.
He tried to go back and find the world's oldest fucking computer.
There was a TV show about being a day. He was one day in the future, and he always got the newspaper. Can't remember the name of it.
I remember what you're
I remember
about.
That. That was a good one. I don't remember. They canceled the damn thing.
I don't remember the name of it. Somebody will probably figure it out.
The thing I never understood time travel things, though, is that if they prevent that from happening, then they'd never know it happened because nothing would have told him it happened because it didn't happen in the first place. But if it didn't happen, then it would happen.
Yeah.
That's why you suck at that job.
Yeah, you're not doing well.
You don't understand it.
Temporal mechanics never made any sense to me.
We need to Neil deGrasse Tyson this bitch up.
Yeah. I don't think that we do.
Have a real guest that can explain time travel. I want you to get on that, Richard.
I'll have a rummage around, see who I can find.
No, you need to get Neil deGrasse Tyson.
I don't think I can get Neil deGrasse Tyson.
You can't even say his name.
I mean, what the fuck?
I can't even say his name, so I've already offended him, so probably not.
How do you know you've offended him? Maybe he forgives you because you're British.
Maybe he does. Maybe I'll use my sleazy British charm to get him on the show.
See, now I would not forgive you for being British. Because as we know, it has become my lifelong passion to drive every British listener from the 40 and Slip.
You're not doing a very good job either.
Shit.
You are incredibly racist against British people.
I'm not.
You are pretty racist.
No.
You said you couldn't tell the difference between a British and Australian accent. That is racist.
It's not racist.
How is that racist?
It's massively racist.
What if I were to go Australians and New Zealanders?
That's even worse.
So,
look, know why that's racist. Then that just proves how disconnected and unfeeling you are.
I think there's not much difference between you and Canadians.
I would expect this kind of behavior from Steve, but not from you, Chris. All right.
But I like Canadians.
When Donald Trump builds his wall, it's going to be to keep you out, Richard.
I think that, like, if he wins the presidency, he should build a wall around the White House and stay in the White House.
Well, technically, there already is a wall.
Yeah.
A bigger one. An electric fence for 4 years.
Just four?
Just 4 years.
You don't think he's going to get reelected?
If he got the presidency?
Right.
If he gets the presidency, which he won't.
Yeah, that's kind of obvious.
So what should the other one do then? Shouldn't she do the same thing?
No, I don't think that anything can stop her, if I'm honest. No,
I don't think so either.
We need to use this your ability, Richard, to be in the future to our advantage. Somehow.
Somehow, okay.
Somehow, some go. Way. So you need to do some research in time travel.
I will figure this out.
It's your job.
Just all I want is who wins the Super Bowl ahead of time.
I want to do a proper time travel episode next week.
Good luck.
Can we do that? No. Is that possible?
Maybe we can time travel Steve so he actually shows up on time for a show.
That could
be. I was taking care of business.
Listen, no one wants to hear about this, Steve. Least of all, Richard and I.
Yeah. No, I'm not on board with this conversation at all.
Listen, great pornos don't start with marital bliss.
They definitely don't start with spam and cowboy hats.
Exactly. So, I mean, come on now.
But that would be a hell of a good porno, though. Spam? Oh, my God. I'd watch it.
They say if you can think of it, there's a porno for it. So there probably already is.
I may have to look it up right now.
I know. Me and my friend Matt did this once. We found lamppost porn and all sorts of porn.
What was that news story I sent to you, Steve? That guy from Ohio that tried to fuck a van?
Yeah. What about it?
Oh, just that was what reminded me of him talking about a guy, a porno about fucking lampposts.
It happens more than you think.
Dude, we did a news story once about a guy in the UK that was, what was he, fucking mailboxes?
Yep.
Yep. There was that guy. And then the guy who married a car, Volkswagen Beetle.
Of course it was a Volkswagen Beetle. Why wouldn't it have been?
Of course it was. I mean, if you're going to marry a car.
No, because you picked out the story, I'm sure.
You'd marry a Chevy, wouldn't you?
No, they did that whole documentary. I think you actually sent it to me. The old guy who... The guys who, you know, have a sexual fetish for vehicles.
I don't think I sent that to you.
I'm sure you did.
No.
Automobilophilia.
I think you're mistaking me for somebody else there, Steve, because I've never sent that to you.
It was a good documentary. They didn't show anything, but, you know, it wasn't like a porn flick or anything.
Did you watch the whole documentary hoping for some man-on-car action?
No, I did not. I watched the whole documentary, but not hoping for man-on-car action.
You just sounded disappointed, Steve. That was all.
I did not sound disappointed. It was just showing that, you know, there was an actual fetish, and it was the old guy, and then there was a young guy. And they traveled across the country to a car show. that was the whole documentary. It was kind of neat.
Shouldn't they go on, like, registries and be forbidden from attending car shows?
I would think, because, you know, when I go to a car show, which I happen to do on occasion, a lot of occasions, you know, most of them have little stickers on their car, do not touch.
Right.
So, yeah.
You'd think there'd be a registry. Because cars can't give their consent as well, it's technically rape, so...
Car rape.
Car rapists.
Some sick motherfuckers out there.
I mean, I suppose I can make a case in court that it was the car's fault for the paint job provocative.
That's just wrong.
Sexy tailpipes. Speaking of which, I put new exhaust tips on my car today. Hey, I'm not a professional, Chris. I don't expect professionalism.
if anyone expects professionalism out of this show, they better fucking turn it off now.
Wasn't it? It was professionalism. It was our very first show that we were told how unprofessional we were.
Oh yes, by one Joe Mastriani.
Yeah,
whatever the fuck his name was.
Oh, I love that guy.
Do you?
I love that guy.
How much?
Well, why don't you tell him? He's been awful depressed lately. Why don't you tell him that you love him? You know, make pick him up a little bit.
Oh, I do love it. I let him into the BBB sometimes. He comes in, he insults everyone, and then he leaves. It's just...
He tells how much better than everybody else he is at what he does.
Yeah. Oh, I'm going to be rich. I'm doing a one-hit wonder. You're all losers. You lose. Oh, the guy's a legend.
What exactly is the BBB? British Bigfoot Bastards?
No, Butcher's Group.
Oh, I have no idea.
You're in it.
And I comment, too, on occasion. I know what it is.
But yeah, Joe did wind up calling us unprofessional and saying we were losers and that our show sucked. Did he wind up playing excerpts from our first show?
Yeah, he did.
Yeah. I don't know why.
The guns, the money, the lawyers.
Mm-hmm.
Episode one,
and we were already told how unprofessional we were.
That was one of your best shows, though.
Well, you know, not according to him.
That was the Hovey V. Polling episode. That whole debacle where Melissa... Is it Hovey, Hoovy? I have to ask this every time, Steve.
I think it's Hovey.
Hovey.
I think it's Cunt Face.
Oh, do you?
Well, it's Melissa Hovey Larson now. She got married.
Oh. Well, anyway, she brought a lawsuit against Phil Polling, and it was dismissed...
Without prejudice,
which means it just kind of sucked all the way around.
It means it never happened legally.
And that was our first episode about that Claude. Wasn't it the Claude picture? Can we say that for the record?
Yeah, well, you know, on that episode, I said that I didn't believe it was, but after the whole lawsuit was done, and I think the guy from Claude released some more photos, and then I realized, yeah, that was definitely the fucking Claude costume. But
yeah,
although I think she still stands by, I don't know, because neither one of them are allowed to talk about it.
Right.
But I'm pretty sure she still stands by the fact that it's not, but hey, at this point, it's a moot point because the whole thing's said and done.
No, it's a moot point.
Whatever.
Yeah.
It's mute because it can't speak.
Yeah, sure. And we introduced our listeners to John Teeter. I don't know if some of them had already fucking heard about him or not, but we did the John Teeter episode not long after that. And
episode two.
Was it episode two?
John Teeter stole my flux capacitor.
Do you got a fucking list there? Or are you just doing this from memory?
Deranged super fan.
Now, did you actually tune in to the first show at the time
it came out? I did not listen to the first show. I listened to the second show.
At the time it came out?
At the time it came out. I was looking at John Teeter's stuff and your show came up.
So not only are you a deranged super fan, you are probably our... You know, the only one who's been with us that long.
No, there have been other people.
No, there are. The Swamp Girl, Frank Smith has been listening for a while.
Oh, Fred Dunn.
Fred Dunn.
Yeah.
Jim Payne, wherever he is now.
I think he's dead.
That seems to be a consensus.
I think he haunts the show.
Yeah, no shit. In the form of your bad humor.
That Mary Jaglansky person, the devoted listener.
Oh yeah, every episode, whether man or woman, because I guess that's in question about who this person is. every I'm fucking episode.
Sure, it's a woman.
Does she actually listen to the episode, or does she just comment?
No. She listens, but she, or he, if the case may be.
It's just
only hears what they want to hear.
If you are listening this far, tell us if you are a guy or a girl so we can give you the appropriate pronoun.
Apparently, I pissed this person off, must have been a long time ago, about some sort of footcast that they had and Dr. Meldrum had, and I still don't know who it is. I still don't remember anything about it, so would you please fucking explain it to me? I've asked, but I get no response. So
she called me the British Matt Knapp, so I'm a fan of hers.
The British Matt Knapp.
But I want, for the record, to say that, you know, because we're she's always accusing me of being in league with Ohio Bill, and
who's Ohio Bill?
Bill Brock. And other people of that nature, and I'm not. I mean, I'm just not. So
okay, no one's accusing you of anything.
Well, I'm not saying it's a bad thing. Chris has had some major difficulties with Ohio Bill, but, you know, I on occasion still have said a few things to him. We don't talk, you know, like constantly, but I'm not in league with Ohio Bill. You know, I'm not like his best buddy or anything.
And Ryan Redding listens pretty regularly as well.
Oh, Ryan. Ryan sent me a message the other day.
Oh.
And I think...
Oh.
Yeah. I think he was talking about one green-faced Mainer that was saying some things about him. Merchant. Michael Merchant, I believe the guy's name is.
Yeah.
And so, Ryan, if you're listening, who gives a fuck what that guy thinks?
Yeah.
Nobody cares anymore. He's irrelevant.
He wants his next 2 seconds of fame on some show that will matter to no one.
The guy literally goes in his backyard because on that video, he looks like he's deep in the woods, but he's not. I mean, I'm sure he lives in Maine, so there's a lot of wooded area, but it's his property. You know, it's not like he's going out real far. Because you could hear the chickens in the background at one part of the video, and he raises chickens. So he's posing as like he's out deep in the woods and shit. The guy's irrelevant anymore. Fuck him. You know? He goes from one thing to another.
Sort of like you.
Sort of like I'm irrelevant. I'm the first person to say I'm irrelevant. I don't know why people still, you know, take heed of what I say.
Neither do I.
I don't know why they ever did.
What was the name of that dumb movie we did for the third episode?
That dumb movie.
The Serpent and the Rainbow.
No, wrong one.
Wasn't third.
The one about
was
the...
Was it the Alaska?
Yeah, it was the Nome Alaska one. I can't
remember. Yeah, that was actually... I actually enjoyed that movie.
Was that the fourth kind? Yeah, the fourth kind.
There were some things... Didn't I say something about how ugly the lead actor was in, or the lead actress was in that movie, and I got... You know, you guys gave me a lot of shit about it.
I think you were talking about the woman who played the supposed real woman.
Right.
I think that's who you were talking about.
Yeah.
Because
my favorite part of that episode is Chris saying that he fell for it as a real documentary.
Oh, yeah. I fucking completely fell for it at first. I was like all in.
Well, it could happen, I suppose.
And then, and of course, I thought that they embellished shit for the movie, you know.
Well, they always do. Yeah.
But at the same time, you know, I did. I've completely admitted that I fell for it. And then Steve was just like, "No, it's bullshit."
That's back when I actually, you know, cared.
Yeah. And not long after that, we did... I'm going to skip over episode 4, because not only did that episode do just piss poorly, it was titled The Power of Chris Compels You.
Oh, I remember that one, yep. Mm-hmm.
But then we get...
I thought the title of that show was probably one of the best that we've ever had. The show itself sucked.
Yeah, just...
It was a terrible show.
It was a horrible, horrible show. Then we did The Mothman. I'm not going to go through all the episodes, but, I mean, hey, fuck you all. We've been doing this for 3 years and 10 days now. We are in our fourth year. And I'd like to go over a few things. Then we did the, not long after that, Richard, we did do The Serpent and the Rainbow
thing. That movie sucked.
In retrospect, yeah. When I was younger, I thought it was really cool. And now I'm like, I want to go back in time and just smack the shit out of my younger self and go, it's a bad movie.
It's Dr. horrible. Allen.
Dr. Allen. I want to hear you scream.
That was the only good part of that movie. He said Dr. Allen. It was great.
Dr. Allen. Yeah, that was interesting. We did MK Ultra. It was a long time ago.
Yeah. I'd like to do another MK Ultra show because there's a lot to that.
Yeah, that's something we...
The Bloody Mary episode, the Urban Myths episode.
Yeah, we did that. We did the Krampus shit, which I'd like to get back into again. You know, I've still not watched that god-awful Krampus movie they made.
How do you know it's god-awful if you haven't seen it?
I don't know, because I heard it was god-awful. I might like it. I should sit down and watch it. Oh, and then Steve's favorite thing in the world to hear about, Norm Glasser.
Oh, by the way, to the same green-faced Maynard, he says that I perpetuated a hoax. I didn't perpetuate anything. I believed it was real. And when we found it was a hoax, we immediately that night did a show explaining that it was a hoax. So
right.
Go fuck yourself.
Is he listening to our show?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, good.
So, like 3 minutes into his not his last video, but the prior one, he says something about Matt Knapp, about, you know, Bigfoot evidence and Matt Knapp. And then he says that I only listened to the first 3 minutes. I didn't listen to see if he said any more. I don't care if he said any more. He's irrelevant. But he said that, you know, I perpetuated a hoax, and then I just now admitted that, you know, it was a hoax, and I did it for YouTube views and hits. But what I said on the last show was that as soon as we found out it was a hoax, we came out. No, we didn't even delay. That night we did a fucking show explaining that it was a hoax and that I was duped. Right. So what I want to say to Merchant is, if you don't like people being honest, then there's something fucking wrong with you. Because we didn't hide the fact that it was a hoax. Period.
Unlike some other people and Lupe Mendoza.
I still believe that a lot of the... Lupe still defends that photograph. I haven't heard Michael Merchant say anything about it in a long time. I don't even know if they're still friends. I don't follow
I'd say it's safe to say that we here, all three of us, are of the opinion that that's just a fallen down tree.
A root ball. It's a root ball on a tree. And to me, it's not definitely not a Bigfoot. But it was the last evidence, quote unquote, that Lupe ever put out. I haven't seen him put anything out after that. I did talk to Lupe a few times after that. He wasn't sore with me, but apparently Michael Merchant was with all of us, except maybe Richard. Although he's probably sore with you now, because
he's very sore with me at the moment.
But anyway, so I continue to think that was just, you know, for a television show.
And speaking of that, we all
auditioned for.
Speaking of Michael Merchant, then we did the Bigfoot Bounty shit.
That's back when we thought maybe, well, was that a pro Bigfoot bounty or anti Bigfoot bounty show? I don't remember.
I think Matt was of the school that he liked it. If I remember correctly,
yeah.
Matt was of the school that he liked it. You and I were both like, ugh.
Matt got busted by Spike
for TV what?
For post,
what?
for posting publicity photos.
Oh, no shit.
That's somebody, I don't know who sent to him. I can't remember.
That's funny.
He didn't get busted. They just asked him to take him down.
Right.
He thought he was allowed to use them because one of the cast members, I believe somebody from Las Vegas, sent them to Matt, but he wasn't allowed to use them. So.
Oh, well.
But, yeah, we were promoting the show because, you know, after all, we did audition for it, me and you.
Right.
I'm
glad neither one of us got it. But
oh, so am I. Look, I'm very glad I did not get on that show. After I heard what it was like for the people,
Well, and look at all of them now. They're all a bunch of, you know, you had Stacey Brown who won the show, and Michael Merchant, and Richter, and Roe, and Justin. Well, you don't barely hear about those two anymore.
Yeah, what happened to Roe Sahibi? Well,
the Bigfoot shit ran its course, and he's on to something else. He's on, what's that, that hashtag show he does on YouTube. That's his new thing.
Oh, so, I hadn't heard about any hashtag show.
It's called That Hashtag Show. It's on YouTube.
Oh, really?
It's somewhat successful. It's not great. Anyway, so most of the people on there are either let it go to their head, like Stacey Brown, although I think it already went to his head well before that show. And Michael Merchant, you know, both of those guys have totally just gone off the wall, in my opinion, allegedly.
Michael Merchant is worrying me a little bit. He just seems to have completely lost his mind.
I don't think he has at all.
No, though, everyone's telling me that. Everyone's saying, Richard, no, he's just an opportunistic weasel, and he might be, but, you know, he just seems to be circling the pipe, so to speak.
Well, I think in the Bigfoot world, he's circling the pipe for sure. And I think he knows that. And I think that's why his videos get stranger and stranger over time, because he's grasping at straws. It's my opinion. I could be wrong. He could be totally woo. You know, he could believe all that shit. I don't know. I don't think so. I knew him we knew him as a skeptic, right? So to go from skeptic to, like, totally the
hardcore believer.
Yeah. There's something going on there. And I don't believe that is because he's seeing
the thing that drew me to that show that they were on. What was it called? Exists?
Yeah.
The thing that drew me to that show was the fact that they were skeptical about the things that they talked about.
Right. And I have to admit, it was a great show.
I wouldn't say it was a great show. It was, at the time, it was enjoyable, but the thing that I liked about it was that they were skeptical. And it just seemed to go down a road of, you know, less and less of that. And then it stopped. And then before you knew it, Michael Merchant was just, he had seen a Bigfoot, and now he's all in. And then he started promoting Johnson, right?
Yeah, he didn't see a Bigfoot until after Bigfoot Bounty.
It was
if memory serves.
I thought it was before.
No, the Lupe Mendoza photograph that Merchant was defending was right before Bigfoot Bounty. And to be, you know, open about things, Lupe was also auditioning for that show. Well, if you have Bigfoot evidence, obviously you're going to have a better chance of getting on the show. What happened with Lupe, why he didn't get on the show, I don't know. I wasn't privy to that information because that's when the whole Team Taser thing went to the toilet because of the Lupe Mendoza thing and some other shit going on. But anyway, so that's what immediately led up to the Bigfoot Bounty show. And then after Bigfoot Bounty, him and Kathy Villarreal, or Lady K as he calls her, that's when they seen the Bigfoot, allegedly, after Bigfoot Bounty.
See, I remember it being before.
He may have claimed one before, or may have, but I don't remember it until after. Not long after, but after. And I'm sure he'll correct me in his next video if I'm wrong.
But after that, though, we did. That was when Rick Dyer was going around and doing his traveling stuffed animal Bigfoot.
Yes. Yes, now I know where we are. You got the Hank video, and then you've got Sheep Pig.
Yeah, well, yeah, Sheep Pig. And then, Sheep Pig was a little before that, but
no. Then we kind of
went off the rails a little bit with some stuff.
You're in the area where you did Save the Creamsicle, Save the World,
right? Which is one of your favorite episodes.
Yep, I take it back. That is probably the best title to a show. Actually, there was another one. I can't remember right now that I thought was better because I came up with it. But other than that, Save the Creamsicle, Save the World was a great episode title.
Best title. Sorry.
Oh, it's all right.
Go ahead.
Go ahead with your best title.
The best title, in my professional opinion, was Do Werewolves Dream of Shapeshifting Sheep?
Yeah, that was not long after.
Because that's right in the Elvis episode.
Yeah, before that was Elvis. And then that was right around the time of the Malaysian jet plane disappearance.
Elvis, by the way, was my idea, right?
Yes, you did.
And that show did real well, did it? Did it not?
For the time that it was released, it did very well for what it was.
You know, there is new information about Elvis.
Fucking Jesus.
Most of those views are me, though. I'm just going to tell you.
But I do have to agree with Richard. The Do Werewolves Dream of Shapeshifting Sheep was probably the better, if not the best, of the titles that I've come up with.
Yeah.
I like that one a lot.
Leaving on a Malaysian jet plane, don't know if I'll be back again.
That's a good one. Yeah.
Then there was the Europa Moon thing.
So what?
So the Malaysian jet plane, though, they found parts of that now, haven't they? I mean, that was all solved, wasn't it?
They claim to have, yeah.
I personally,
but it was a big mystery. It was a big mystery when it happened. I mean, several months before there was any break in it, I think.
Well, it's still a mystery. Nobody knows what happened to it. How many bits of it showed up?
Oh, it was a government plot of some sort from some government that plots against them.
Aliens, personally.
I think that was one of the theories we talked about on one of the shows. It was a shot down by a UFO.
There were all kinds of theories. Teenage aliens. Making YouTube videos.
False flag.
Here, check this out.
Hey,
this
will be good. Yeah, exactly.
that was around, and then after that was when we did the, I think we did the, The Men Who Stare at Goats. We watched that movie.
Which you it's didn't like, but I did.
No, I like the men. Movies. I love The Men Who Stare at Goats. It's a great movie.
No, maybe it was the other way around. Maybe you liked it and I didn't.
Yeah, and I'm pretty sure I liked it.
I don't know. I have short-term memory.
It's an awesome film. And more of it, it's true than you actually believe.
And then we did the show that Steve completely missed, which was...
I missed a show?
Yeah, the Russian Yeti show. The first one that we did.
Oh, yeah.
The Killer Lives.
You and Matt only,
yeah,
I remember.
Yeah, that was Matt and I.
Sure, I had some important business to take care of that night.
Yeah, I'm sure.
You were in porn rehab.
Yeah. We did Willow Creek.
Still haven't seen that.
You still haven't seen Willow Creek? Bobcat.
You're not missing much.
Bigfoot movie.
Here. I'll go ahead.
Found footage is my favorite genre, so it's weird that I haven't seen that yet.
Okay, here's the plot of the movie. It's a found footage film, so think of every other found footage film.
Yeah, I know. There's exactly
throw the Bigfoot in the mix, and that's it. That's the whole film.
And that's what you get.
I love found footage films because the whole film is based on the premise that no matter what happened, somebody kept the camera rolling. And once you accept that, then everything else is just pretty easy by comparison.
But I thought that movie was... Yeah. I mean, the plot wasn't that good.
And it's on YouTube.
The ending, it just didn't. It made sense, but it didn't make sense. I just didn't. Yeah, it wasn't my favorite.
Well, speaking of found footage, did you see that either re-releasing or remaking the Blair Witch?
It's a completely new movie.
Oh, for God, why?
I don't know. Because don't ask me. I don't make the fucking things.
It makes him money.
Okay.
Why else would he do it, right? Isn't he just did a Bigfoot flick too, didn't he?
Who?
Yeah.
I can't think of his name right now.
Who?
Eduardo, wasn't it? Eduardo something. The guy from the Blair Witch.
Is he doing the new movie though?
Well, I'm assuming so. Why wouldn't he? I mean, it's his franchise, right?
I don't know.
You wouldn't think he would sell his name or the rights to that away. I wouldn't. It was the most successful found footage movie in the world.
It was also the worst. I mean, if it was me, I would have...
It doesn't matter.
I would have distanced myself.
You would have distanced yourself from the money that he made off of that film.
I'd have kept the money, but...
Of course you would have.
Not acknowledged it at all.
And then you would have done the second one. Because you know that you're going to make more money.
The Book of Shadows isn't that bad when you compare it to the first one.
If you're going to go found footage movies, I have to go Cloverfield.
Amazing film. But my personal favorite is Alien Abductions.
I haven't seen any.
We watched that one, didn't we?
I know you've seen Alien Abductions. You reviewed it.
I did?
Yeah. Yeah, you did.
It was a found footage film?
Yeah, redneck gets...
Huh? We did watch that movie, gets... Steve. Unless that's one of them that you tried to act like you watched and just let Matt and I carry the show.
I think that might be the one. There was one that I didn't watch.
No, he watched it because he watched the after credits scene.
I did?
Yeah.
Oh.
See,
with police patrol car, we found another one. It's the dad.
I don't recall.
Oh,
some boys.
It was a found footage film.
Yeah.
Huh.
I think you're doing this deliberately.
No, I'm not. I really don't recall this film.
You were the only one out of all three of them that watched the after credits scene. Matt and Chris had switched it off in disgust.
You're trying to argue the point with the fucking superfan, Steve.
Yeah.
Well, I believe that I did. I just don't recall doing it.
Steve, if you can't recall watching the movie...
You see, I think there's something seriously wrong.
Ancient aliens.
I gotta
tell you guys a story. I had a dream... that I spoke to David Childress. And that
you need to stop doing the act, the impression.
No. Did you speak to him with the impression or?
No, literally the dream went like that. I met him. I don't know how I met him, like, but I wound up at his house in my dream and I asked him if he'd do the show and he agreed. And I told him I wanted to do the voice.
Huh.
Was he fine with you doing the voice?
Yeah, he was cool.
Huh.
Well, let's try to make that happen.
Dream Childress took it on the chin.
I would so love to have him on the show, but you know damn well he's not going to do the show.
Well, Dream Childress does.
I know.
He wants to.
That's my perfect
dream world. But real Childress, no.
They say that in the dreams you do what you really want to, so obviously Childress really wants to do this show.
You think so?
Dream logic. Can't argue with logic.
This was Chris's dream, not Childress's dream.
Yeah. I know, that was a joke. Jesus fucking... Move on.
I didn't get it.
No.
I get it now.
I'm either... Yeah.
Now that you explain it to me, I understand.
I'll just explain every single joke from now on, just to make sure that you're keeping up with it.
Oh, you know, you don't know how many I really don't get, but I pretend I do.
Oh,
lots
God.
Of them.
But yeah, I'd love to have somebody like that on the show. Of course I would.
I think Sugalos would be more willing than Childress, though.
I don't think so.
Cut him a fat paycheck.
I don't think so. Sugalos is big hair.
Yeah, well, I think happening. He'd do it.
No. His hair's...
There's got to be somebody out there.
His hair's gotten way too big, Steve. And that's, you know, to keep together that big head that he's got from Ancient Aliens.
I don't know. There's got to be somebody out there who listens to us that has a connection to either Childress or Sugalos that can get him on the show.
Derek Randall's did a show with him, didn't he?
Oh, yeah. But he's not going to do us any favors.
No, Derek Randall's isn't doing us any favors.
How have you managed to piss off Derek Randall?
I don't think I have.
Okay, here's the thing.
I don't know how we managed to do anything.
Here is the thing, okay? Allegedly, maybe, possibly, one Derek Randall's had said that he would do the show. And, okay, it wasn't alleged. He did say he'd do the show and then canceled, like, I don't know how many times in a row. And finally, I got fed up. And that's why.
Say no more.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because as we all know, I'm pretty cutthroat when it comes to yes. bullshit.
We all know that you're a fair and balanced person. That.
Well, he did have, you know, family obligations and you know, big pudding takes second backseat to that sort of thing.
Two-faced little weasel.
No. I'm going somewhere with this, Richard. He had obligations other than Bigfooting because, you know, Bigfooting's just a hobby.
It's just a hobby, Steve. Don't worry about it.
But I don't think I've managed to piss Derek Randall's off yet. Maybe I have now.
It's possible. You know, because, you know, when you do run pretty much like the Olympic Project,
It's not a full-time job. It's not a full-time job for anybody.
Oh, now I get it. Now I'm with you. Right. Okay.
It's not a full-time job for anybody. But when you run an organization that puts as much time into looking for something as the Olympic Project allegedly does, then it's a little more than a hobby. Or it should be.
Yeah. Anywho. But yeah, that's why I don't think he's going to be helping me out anytime soon.
No. So we can forget that connection.
Now, Steve Culls did do our show.
He did, absolutely did.
And Steve, I like Steve, but his humor was, oh God, like he's like Alcorn. Just fucking bad quip after bad quip. Holy shit.
I mean, no wonder they're such good chums.
I know they hang out, they drink.
I've only hung out with them a couple times, and I've never had any alcoholic beverage with Mr. Culls. I have had calamari, though.
Alcohol.
He eats with
Steve. Well, you said we drink. When you say you drink, generally people are going to say,
you mean you didn't have a beverage?
I had a beverage.
All right, so
I said he was your jolly good chum. I didn't mention drinking.
You did.
I said jolly good chum.
I don't. You mentioned drinking. Hanging Are you out. Trying to screw with my brain?
Always,
no, Steve.
Every fucking episode.
No, kudos to Ed Carls for doing our show. I mean, a lot of people don't want to do it because of the way our show is.
Right? No,
he didn't. He didn't give a fuck.
No, Steve didn't give a shit, and he was cool about it. And I talked to him about it beforehand and told him, you know, hey, this is the way we are, and, you know, take it or leave
it.
And
he joined right in.
Yeah.
No, he joined right in. It was great.
Yeah. Because we have not had many people on this show.
No.
Very few. Wait a minute. Let's see. The list is Steve Culls.
No, you had you and Matt did a show.
You interviewed that comic guy.
Gene St. Gene, that was a little different. That wasn't necessarily the Freudian slip. And I directed people to Gene St. Gene the last episode we did. Yeah, when we had Matt on, because that guy is great. And if you haven't checked out Gene St. Gene's artwork, please do so. If I can remember, I'll put the links underneath YouTube. If not, just search for him. Gene St. Gene, he's a sculptor. He does like comic action figures or figures. Not so much. Well, he does a little bit of both. You know, he does. But his work is amazing. Didn't he do the creature replica things too?
I'm pretty sure. Boggy Creek.
The one that Matt and I interviewed him about was the Boggy Creek one sculpture. But yeah, if you haven't checked him out, definitely check out Gene St. Gene. But
you also have Bob Dominguez on an episode.
Oh yeah, Bob Dominguez, who read the news worse than I do.
Yeah. Good old Bobby D.
Did he? I actually went back and listened. I rarely listen to our shows. I rarely go back and listen, but I missed that one. I think my son had baseball or something. And yeah, not so good. He was great during the show, I thought.
That was the one about the Bigfoot with the glowing penis.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I didn't get to take part in the, you know.
You missed out on glowing penis Bigfoot.
You referenced that for like a year afterwards.
Really?
Yeah.
Sometimes he still does, I believe.
No, it's stuck in his memory.
Bob Dominguez is the chupacabra hunter, I believe.
Yes.
There's no such fucking thing as a chupacabra.
Tell Bob Dominguez that.
That's right.
I just did. Bob Dominguez. There is no such thing as a fucking chupacabra.
What about Slender Man?
Oh, listen.
That's even worse.
The Slender Man obviously exists. I killed like 12 sacrificed to him.
Is there just one Slender Man?
Did you hear my utter silence after you said that?
Yeah, sure.
Good.
Is there a Slender
Man? I'm tired. I'm going to his mansion after I die now, though. So, yeah, he's Slender Man.
Those two girls that tried to kill that other girl so that they could appease the Slender Man.
To be fair, you know, I've heard of worse plans.
I can't throw one off.
Throw one out there, Richard.
The Mayans used to sacrifice children to appease their gods.
Yeah, okay. But it's been...
And that was sacrificing a child.
It's been proven that the Slender Man started on a website as basically a joke.
Yeah, and so did every single god that exists today.
I don't think they started as jokes.
I'm pretty sure they did.
I'm not, you know, I'm not a religious man by any means, but people have been...
So sure comedians back in the day were like, two gods walked into a bar.
I'm pretty sure a bunch of goat herds were sitting around a fire with some mead, and one of them said, you know what would be really funny? And it just got out of hand. Okay.
I think gods and religion were basically made up to explain things that we can't explain or couldn't at the time, and has just gone on from there. But I don't think they were jokes to begin with.
Would somebody create a god so that we can understand Alcorn?
There is even a god couldn't do that. I'm sorry.
Since we create gods to explain things that we don't understand.
Well, I think that's why religion in the first place was, you know, created. That's just my opinion. I'm probably wrong.
And no, I agree completely with
you. I may end up in hell. There is a place.
Well, you know.
Oh, that's where you're going. You'll have some company.
If there is a place such as hell, I'm pretty sure at this point, after doing this show for 3 years, that I will be there.
Everybody else will be there too, so don't worry about it.
Yeah, but it has been a fucking 3-year ride so far. We are on our 4th year. How the fuck did we make it?
I mean, I love doing the show with you guys, but I just want Matt to come back. I just want Matt back.
I don't think that's going to happen anytime soon. He's pretty successful with his other ventures.
Yeah, he's doing well.
And
yeah, no, well,
great.
Wish him well.
Great for him.
And don't get me wrong, I'd love to have him back.
Oh, yeah. Last week we had a great show. I mean,
not last week. It was like 2 weeks ago.
Well, whatever. But speaking of last week, Chris.
Yes.
I didn't cancel that one.
No, that was me.
Yep, I'm sure you were taking care of business.
Taking care of business.
I may have been.
Yep. See, and allegedly, and I get in trouble for being late. You know,
What are you trying to insinuate, Steve?
Verbally molested for being late because I was taking care of business.
All right, I'm going to settle this. I know for a fact Chris has cancelled like 2 or 3 times ever when we have done shows, and he's always upfront and honest about it. You, on the other hand, decide the time and then don't show up at that
time. Oh, God. Hey, you know, when there's business, you got to take care of it.
What, every time? Every time?
No, most of the time it's because I'm picking my son up from youth group and he's late.
Okay. Fair enough.
Most of the time.
Just saying, Steve. It's out there.
On that note, do you have some news?
Oh, we're done? Okay.
Yeah, well, yeah.
Well, done with the main portion of the show. Now it's, you know, news time.
What did you expect?
Yes, I have news.
We didn't have a topic tonight, Steve.
When's the last time we actually did?
Have a topic?
Yeah.
I kind of think we did the last show we did. We talked about Bigfoot hoaxes.
I mean a planned topic.
Oh, a planned topic.
Never. Yeah,
that's been a while.
It's probably been 2 out of the 3 years.
What do you want from me,
Steve? I know.
When's the last time we cared?
If I know what
when's the last time we really gave a shit?
5 minutes before the show starts, that's advanced warning.
Yeah?
Isn't there any news like music? So that Richard can hum along with it?
Yeah, no.
I'm muting.
Daily Star. I guess there's a human-like monster that was caught walking on camera in the desert, and some people think it's a Bigfoot.
Phil did this one, didn't it? It's a CGI.
Well, then why the fuck should I even read the story when you gave away the ending?
I'm sorry, Steve.
I don't think it's the same. I don't know. Has Phil done any videos recently? I
haven't spoiler noticed. Alert. Yeah, spoiler alert.
My bad, guys. I'm sorry.
I've only seen a still of this video. And I can tell you just from the still of the video that it's CGI. But anyway, yeah, the odd beast can be seen walking slowly.
That's not a shaved Bigfoot in the desert?
No. It can be slowly seen walking for a brief few seconds before disappearing behind a bush. It was filmed in Portugal, well known for their Bigfoots, I guess. Some have compared the creature's movements to that of a Bigfoot. Its hind legs give it human-like quality, but the hunchback and long arms mimic that of the legendary creatures. Other people thought it was the
or old people with really bad backs.
Some say.
Are you going to finish that sentence or
no? It is. Oh, never. Anyone who listens to an explained universe,
I know what it means. But
all right then. Carry on the story.
Anyway, the clip was posted on YouTube, went viral after being viewed more than 200,000 times. But some viewers were a little skeptical, including one Mr. Para Breakdown that says it's CGI. Apparently.
Bob?
I don't think it's just his opinion. I think it's just common sense if you see the video.
Yeah, I'm looking at a still right now. And it's clearly not any viable creature. It wouldn't be able to. And how do you get chupacabra? Some people thought it was a chupacabra. How do you get chupacabra from a...
They don't. You're saying that to irritate me.
No, it says Chupacabra right in the story.
I don't believe you.
Chupacabras are real.
Send him the link. Send him the link, Chris.
Bob Dominguez, Chupacabra Hunter.
Oh, okay.
From the worst named website on the internet, in my opinion. Sputnik News.
Oh, fuck. Get over it, Steve. Get over
Sputnik
it.
Sputnik hasn't been around for, what, 50 years?
Neither has Slick Toys.
There's no news about Sputnik anymore.
There's no news about Slick Toys.
So they have to go... Fuck yourself. They have to go with UFO news. So we're going to read a UFO news from a Sputnik website.
Okay.
It's in space.
Well, yeah. Well, no, this one's closer to Earth. But UFO fleet swarms over a super volcano. It's the volcano is believed to be an alien base. I don't know who.
Have you ever seen Star Trek Into Darkness?
No.
They were stopping it exploding.
Oh, okay. Chilling footage reveals several large UFOs flying over the gigantic Yellowstone supervolcano, which alien hunters now suggest may be an alien base right there in Yellowstone. I'm sorry. Who comes up with this shit?
Why don't they all go have a look inside the volcano and tell us if there's an alien base there?
Steve, if you've got UFOs over the supervolcano, it's got to be.
You travel for thousands of light years.
Ancient aliens.
The best place you can find to make your base is inside a volcano.
It just doesn't make much sense. Things have happened.
Maybe they like it hot, Steve.
Yeah, maybe they're reptiles.
Sweeping through the clouds above Yellowstone National Park in Wyoming appears to be what looks like a massive flying cylinder more than 300 feet long above a gigantic supervolcano that has been dormant. Oh, it's dormant. So there you go. For over 70,000 years. While scientists have long suspected that an eruption of the massive volcano could kill some 100,000 people,
wait a minute. If they're reptiles, winter, is this going to be like V?
I don't know. Yes. That was a good series. I watched that when I was a kid.
Oh my God, something Steve's watched. Moment of silence. Moment of silence to appreciate this.
Well, it reminded... No, I'm not going to observe this moment of silence, seeing it's in honor of me.
This is what happens when I make an effort. You hear this, Dean Cooper? This is what happens when you make an effort.
But Dean thinks that I should, you know, like, go postal on you too.
Dean talks to his parrots. Dean is two sandwiches short of a picnic.
Dean, I think, was even going to, you know, send me some money so that I have gas to go up to Maine. I don't think he had enough for me to fly to the UK.
You coming to have some lobster?
You going to do some mushrooms with Chris?
No, I'm supposed to carry out some sort of plan that I guess I'm supposed to come up with myself.
Dean, if you've got some kind of final solution in mind, Steve Alcorn is not the best agent in the world.
Jason Bourne, Steve is not.
I'd forget where I was going halfway.
He's like the anti-Bourne.
I can't even remember watching the credits of some sort of alien.
Just because Steve wears a fucking cowboy hat doesn't mean he's Rooster Cogburn.
We programmed all this special defense into your mind. Yeah, I forgot.
I was reading a story, I think, about Yellowstone. Oh, wait. UFO hunters believe that the explosive mound of molten lava serves as a feeding source. Oh, okay. For alien life forms drawing on the volcanic energy. They eat volcano stuff. Weird. Live footage monitoring the park captured a fleet of saucers hovering past the volcano. The footage shared by Jeanette Forrester.
It's a UFO, Steve.
The footage was shared by a Jeanette Forrester via YouTube, and she describes it as a once-in-a-lifetime video that she believes shows the presence of extraterrestrial beings.
E.T.?
It probably doesn't.
It's if they have an alien base in this volcano, how can it be a once-in-a-lifetime video? Wouldn't they be there all the time?
Yeah, maybe in her lifetime, because they're going to kill her now that they know she has the video.
What is the plan of these aliens living in this super volcano? Are they, like, are they going to cause the eruption that kills us all? Is that what's going to happen?
They're going to buy up the world supply of Cheetos.
This is what happens. This is what happens when we let Richard pick a story. BBC.com.
It's half three, Chris. Fuck off.
So, thieves in New Zealand, the city of Wellington, are in for a nasty surprise if they open their spoils from a recent robbery. Criminals stole a box marked chemicals from the back seat of a conservation company's pickup truck on Sunday, possibly expecting drug-making materials. The New Zealand Herald reports, however, the box contained nothing but 16 bottles of an experimental and foul-smelling oil made from the anal glands of stoats.
What's a stoat?
What?
Yeah, it's what's a stoat?
Big ferret. It's a big weasel.
Oh, I should have known.
Robbie Van Dam, director of Good Nature Company. I mean, this is what happens when we let Richard pick a news story. It has nothing to do with, like, paranormal stuff or Bigfoot or UFOs.
No, of course it doesn't. It's about stoats and ferrets and mustelids, important things.
Robbie Van Dam, director of Good Nature Company, which owns the Noxious Brew, said the gland oil is... This is a boring story. The gland oil is part of a national effort... A national effort to rid New Zealand of foreign predators such as stoats. See, they're foreign predators.
You know what? The last time Chris let you pick a story, it was about poop.
Well, I like poop stories.
Yeah, just say, what's Fortean about poop?
I'm sure there was some sort of Fortean aspect to the story. Maybe it was ghost poop.
Ghost poop, right.
No. Well, sometimes we have funny stories, but this one's just, you know, they picked up some, basically, you know, oil, anal oil. I guess it is funny.
They were going to make drugs, and they got ass juice. What's not funny about that?
No, I see that side of it now. I mean, anal fluid. It's great.
And if you've ever smelled one of these animals, it is foul.
Thank you. I want to thank you, Steve, for that drop for the new intro.
I haven't been close enough to a stoat's ass to smell it.
You don't need to get just, their ass. You
just
need to
keep digging them. That hole for the new intro, Steve. Just keep digging it.
Okay, Richard, explain this to me. How does having anal gland oil from the stoat repel stoats?
I don't know.
Because that's what they're trying to do. They want to rid New Zealand.
It's a repellent. It's not an extermination device. I imagine they're using the scent of big, powerful males, which will scare off other... Or they're using it to trap ferrets and stoats.
So they're going to spread this shit all over New Zealand.
Yeah, stoats are a real problem over there.
Well, yeah, to drive out the stoats, also rats and possums, apparently. So the whole country's going to smell like stoat ass.
For a few days. I mean, it's for the greater good.
So you think just a few days is going to, you know, drastically decline the population of stoats?
Nothing's going to drastically decline the population.
So the country's going to smell like shit for no real purpose.
You know what, Steve? Just you pick the stories in the future.
Just saying.
Just say.
Oh, as an addition to the story, they do say that the thieves did actually try to smoke the stoat ass fluid.
And you said it wasn't funny.
I don't know. I made that part up. But I'm betting they did try. I'm betting they tried to make meth with it anyhow. Because, you know, it's probably just as good as what... Yeah, I make a lot of parts of these stories up. And most of the time, I just don't say it. But you know what's in meth? This is probably no worse.
It'd be like Breaking Bad with stoats. Oh, I need to sleep. Finish up.
They do say the word poop in this article, but I'm not going to read that part.
That's great.
Poop.
Are you done?
Yeah.
Good.
You want to strangle him.
Severely.
You want to reach through the monitor and just be like, shh.
I don't so much want to. I don't so much want to strangle him. I want to find out that Steve died, like the lead singer of INXS.
Never listen to them.
This has been episode 125 of the 40 and Slip. If you like this shit, hit the thumbs up button. If you don't, hit the thumbs down button. Leave a comment. Subscribe. Check out Fred Dunn, Dread Fun, at youtube.com/DreadFun. That's DREDFUNN. Check out Richard's blog if you're so inclined.
I call people cunt.
The link is underneath the YouTube video. You can check out Steve if you'd like. We prefer that you don't.
There ain't nothing. There's nothing to check.
Check out Matt Knapp at youtube.com/BigfootCrossroads. And next week, we will try to come back with a wonderful time travel episode. Maybe. See ya!